Let's start the meeting.
Okay, am I audible? Okay. Hello, eloquent professionals. Good evening. And today we are in 20th e-meet of the eloquent professionals, and I'm Sachin Deshpande, today's sergeant at arms. So everyone has a mission. So even me, each and every individual under this roof is also having a mission. In the same way, our eloquent professional also has got a mission, which to provide to a platform, a supportive platform and a learning platform to each and every eloquent professionals to improve their communication and leadership skills so that they can improve their confidence and their personal growth. So with this, I would like to start the session. So I would encourage all people to participate in today's eloquent professional session and to make it successful. As we know that today's the theme of the day is that consistency is not a secret to success, but the success itself. And the idiom of the day is that shoot yourself in the foot. So I would encourage all the participants, the prepared speakers to use this particular word, idiom in the speak and make it more successful. Further, we all know the rules and regulations of the meeting, but I would like to reiterate the same for the another time so that all newcomers can understand the rules. So try to avoid talking about the controversial issues like which can be related to politics or a sex or a religion or any other topics which you yourself judges as a sensitive. Further, use your mobile or a laptop in a very good manner and try to put it on a switch. If you're using the mobile, try to put it on the silent so that it will not disturb you over the meeting. Further, to talk about today's topic, we know that we hope everyone knows that Bruce Lee, about Bruce Lee. He made one statement. He said that I'm not afraid of the person who practice 10,000 kicks, but I'm afraid of that person who practice the same kick for 10,000 times. So this is the level of the consistency which everyone should develop with in order to make our mission or whatever that we desire to achieve. And we all know that consistency is not within the cup of the most of the people. And also we should agree that the moment when you start being a consistent and the success will follow for you for sure. And in fact, our team also says that that itself is a success. So with this brief talk about the topic of the day, I would like to introduce our presiding officer, CA Siddesh Gaddi. Welcome you, sir. And to brief about our presiding officer, he's a young and dynamic chartered accountant who is involved in predominantly in the field of income tax litigation, and he is also a mentor for most of us. And it happens that he's also a chairman of our committee, and he's also my senior doing my articleship course. And he's a very, as far as my opinions are concerned, he's a very humble person. He is like available for all the people at all the time, even though he's a busy. And with this brief introduction, I would like to hand over the session to our presiding officer, CA Siddeshwadi. Thank you, sir. Over to you.
Thank you, CA Sachin. A very warm good evening to all the eloquent professionals. You may validate, you may greet me back by showing thumbs up. Thank you, thank you. I feel privileged, I feel lucky enough to be introduced by CA Sachin. He's a very good friend. I'm not a senior, I'm just his friend. Thank you, Sachin, for being a good friend and good support. As a presiding officer for Eloquent Professionals Meet, I would like to declare this meeting to be open. Having said this, pardon me for repeating the mission of Eloquent Professionals. I've been repeating this week after week. I've been repeating this even after Sachin has mentioned it very clearly. The mission of Eloquent Professionals is to ensure that everybody who is present here ensures mastery when it comes to public speaking. mastery when it comes to communication skills and mastery when it comes to leadership skills. That is the sole purpose of we gathering here in today's meeting. Having said that, I would like to congratulate each and every member who is present in today's meeting, because it is a landmark meeting. The reason why I'm saying this is because it is 20th online meeting and 46th meeting of Eloquent Professionals. It is a very young club. It has not been even a year since we have started this particular club. Yet, all the members who are present here have been consistent in approach, which is highly appreciated. They've been consistent when it comes to preparation and planning for this event. They've been consistent when it comes to presenting to the best of their abilities. They've also been consistent in moving towards their goals, which is highly appreciated, which is what the theme is all about. I would like to acknowledge the fact that the theme has been inspired by Sikasa Speakers Forum, and that is the sole reason why we have two chief guests in today's meeting who are part of Sikasa Speakers Forum. When I invited them for this event, they were a little skeptical. They were rather humble. They were asking me whether we should actually be chief guest or general evaluator for today's session. The only thing which I mentioned, which I actually wanted to mention, is that they do have all the rights in the world to be general evaluator, to be chief guest in today's Eloquent Professionals meeting. The only reason is because they've been consistent in their approach, and that consistency has rewarded them to the maximum. We have Madam Lakshmi, who has been vice chairman of Sikasa, of Bangalore branch, of SIRC, of ICI. We have Mr. Avadhoot Vishal, who has made it to almost the helm of the affairs. He has represented in national level elocution contest conducted by ICF. We are privileged to have them. I acknowledge their presence. Having said that, very small my take on theme of the day. Before I give my take on theme of the day, I would like to request each and every person who is present in today's meeting to answer one simple question. I want to know from this learned audience, what do you think is the most muscular animal in this world? I would want you all to leave your answer in the comment box. What do you think is the most muscular animal in this world? Avadhoot Vishal is of the opinion that it is shark. Well received. Any other answers? One more answer, I will proceed. Tongue. Yes, sir. Tongue is powerful, may not be muscular. Lakshmi is of the opinion that it is sea lion. Yes, well received. Thank you for the response. I'll come back to this particular question, which is actually a very important question according to me. Elephant. Thank you, Kusum. I'll come back to that. So my take on theme of the day, pardon me for again taking reference of Honorable Arvind Dhatar, senior advocate. People often, maybe they frown upon me or maybe they curse me for citing examples of lawyers. I can always speak about lawyers because that is all I know. I can always speak about income tax because that is all I know. I don't know GST, I don't know FEMA, I don't know Companies Act. And I'm not Drone Pratap to speak about something which I don't know. So pardon me for this citation. Arvind Dhatar, any and every CA firm which has got reasonable practice in Central Excise must have a book authored by Arvind Dhatar. He's so prominent. He's got written a landmark book on Central Excise. Not any and every CA office which has got reasonable practice in income tax must have a book called as Law and Practice of Income Tax, written by Nani Falkiwala, co-authored by Kanga, his senior. Since Nani Falkiwala is no more with us, this book is being co-authored or maybe updated by Arvind Dhatar. In the very recent past, we have got a publication, 2020 edition. Arvind Dhatar has expressed his apprehensions. He is of the opinion that attempting to write a commentary on income tax is nothing less than lighting a candle in front of a sun. because there are so many legends in this profession. Income tax is a very old act, 1961. On daily basis, we get amendments. On daily basis, we get circulars, notifications, whatnot, rulings of many ITATs, many high courts, and the Supreme Court. Law is fast changing, and writing a commentary which is up to date is a very big task. So Arvind Athar has successfully attempted it. It has been a bestseller even to this date. Arvind Athar takes comfort, or maybe places reliance, on one quote. I do have this book, which is a privilege to have this book. I do have this book. I will cite from this particular book itself what Arvind Athar has to say. The quote which he, which is his inspiration, which is what he follows, which is what he has followed to attempt writing a book on income tax. I would like to repeat: a small daily task, a small daily task, if it be really daily, will beat the labors of a spasmodic Hercules. What a significant statement. At the risk of repetition, because it is very important, I would like to repeat it once again. A small daily task, if it really be daily, will beat the labors of spasmodic Hercules. Spasmodic Hercules appears to be a very funky word, maybe from Shakespeare language. I would like to maybe spend a minute explaining what spasmodic Hercules means. Every now and then we all get these noble thoughts. Let's become good at income tax. Let's master FEMA. Let's master Companies Act. Let's master GST. Let's master communication skills. Every now and then we all take these efforts. Once in a while we all are good. We all take some action, some or the other action towards our goals. But it is, the problem is, it is only every now and then. That is what Hercules is all about. But if it is done on daily basis, it can beat the efforts of spasmodic Hercules. That is what the essence of this book is all about. I'm so proud. I'm so happy that I came across a book like this. Also so happy that I came across a quote like this. And I intend, I'm no great like, again, Dhruvan Pratap. I only intend to just follow this quote which is there in this book, which is worth close to about 8,000 rupees. This book is complete worth to its every penny only because of this quote. So powerful quote. Coming to the question which I had asked to all the learned members who are present here today, I had asked you all to mention the most muscular animal. Elephant is not muscular, it is actually a bull. Bull is the most muscular animal. Elephant may be elephant, fat, but bull is the most muscular animal as per science, as per some facts which I come across. It is not even a whale. The quote given by Sun Tzu, Chinese strategist similar to Chanakya, who was here. We have somebody who in China, Sun Tzu, he mentions, he is of this opinion that a small ant on the move can get more things done than a sleeping bull. Bull is the most powerful, ant is nothing. But still, ant can get more things done than a sleeping bull. We all may be bull, we all may be blessed with one or the other thing, but unless you are an ant, I'm of the opinion, humble opinion, that you will reach nowhere in life. It's been close to about 3 decades of existence in my life, my experience. I have not come across even one person who is on the right path and has failed. I have not come across even one person who has been consistent in his approach and has failed. So that is the, that has been my learning. That has been my take on theme of the day. Hope you got something to learn from this, my take on theme of the day. Thank you for the acknowledgement. Thank you all. You all been consistent. That is very encouraging. I would like to thank you for that. That being said, let's now proceed with the regular conduct of the meeting. You got very interesting person who is present here to take us through this meeting. I would like to, before I introduce that person, I got introduction which is already there in the book in the form of quote. I'll read the quote and then I'll attempt to introduce this legend. The quote is, to set a lofty example, is the richest bequest a man can leave behind him. So the person who is going to take us forward has definitely set an example by just taking part in this particular meeting. He's been a support, he's been a friend, he's been a mentor, he's a senior who we should all look forward to. The only thing, the main thing which I like in his conduct is devotion. Devotion is a very strong word, I keep on using it. Devotion to anything and everything which you do is something which will take you to places in addition to consistency. So he's been an example to many people who are present here today. He is also somebody who updates on a regular basis. He's a person who is an ant. He may not look like ant, I may look like ant, but he is the person who has all the traits of the ant. I don't know if you all have noticed the way ant works, tirelessly, never gets tired. Second, every second they keep on moving towards the goal. They build huge ant nests. Similar to that, we have got C.S. Satish. I'm very happy that he is going to be back on for today's meeting. With that brief introduction, I would like to welcome C.S. Satish to take forward this meeting, sir.
Thank you, Sandeep, sir. Am I audible? Is there any echo going on?
Audible, sir. You're audible. Clear.
Thank you, Siddhesh sir. Friends, I am really moved by the introduction which our charismatic and adorable chairman of the forum, Siddhesh sir, always tries to inspire us. I am really, what do you call, moved by, touched by his words. It's really motivating. We have such mentors who in fact are the fulcrum of this forum. Without their presence, without their motivation, we wouldn't have been able to come this far. Despite difficulties in having programs being conducted physically, we have been able to do this consistently. And that is the theme of the day. Consistency is not secret to success, but success itself. So good evening, eloquent professionals. I welcome you all for today's virtual meeting that is being beautifully decked up with loads of energy and high octane deliberations. As we have lined up interesting speakers who are going to speak their mind out. Then you can catch out for the table topic master who's going to put on the spotlight to let the butterflies out of your tummy. Then finally, we are going to witness an interesting analysis of today's meeting, which is going to be evaluated by our distinguished guest cum general evaluators. So we have not one, but two general evaluators for today's evening. Okay, shoot yourself in the foot is the idiom of the day, which means to inadvertently make a worse for oneself. Okay, if I were to take an example, the company must stop shooting itself in the foot if it wants to get over its trouble. What it means is, if a company is not doing well, it has to actually have some strategic move so that it is able to wade off the trouble which it is in. So I urge the participants to use the idiom of the day as well as the theme during the course of today's meeting. So to get started, friends, it's an honor and pleasure that we are graced by the presence of two personalities who are donning their role as the general evaluators for today. A bubbling, energetic, and tenacious personality was pursuing her CA final year of articleship. She has worked in the risk mitigation team for Society General. She was the vice chairperson of Sikasa Bangalore and the past president of Sikasa Students Forum, a very active and helpful risk to the student fraternity. She's always approachable and also down to earth. She is an avid book reader and a keen nature lover, and gardening being a passion. Friends, please put your hands together in welcoming our first general evaluator, Miss Lakshmi Shenoy. Please show up your thumbs, acknowledging her presence.
Evaluation of the past is the first step towards vision for the future. Good evening to respected president and fellow eloquent members. Today, my role as a general evaluator Am I audible, sir? Yeah. Today, my role as a co-general evaluator is to evaluate the meeting, and I would be evaluating on the prepared speech part, and the next part of the meeting would be evaluated by my co-evaluator. Thank you. Over to you, Satish, sir.
Thank you, Ms. Lakshmi. Okay, now another interesting personality I would love to introduce to you all is a person who believes he can enthrall his audience through his mesmerizing performance with his flute. Give him a book, you would love to grab it and enjoy reading it. You could call him a bookworm. That's more suitable, I believe. He's a great public speaker cum orator who had contested at the All India level in the national level elocution contest, which Siddhesh sir just mentioned a few minutes back. So he was one amongst the top notch guys who was able to make up to the ICI's talent hunt national level elocution contest. And he also has a craze for cars. That's what it keeps his spirits high, along with he being a food junkie. So friends, please put your hands together in welcoming our second general evaluator, Mr. Vishal. Over to you, Mr. Vishal.
Thank you, sir, for the kind introduction. Today is probably the most humbling day that I've faced. Probably a day I needed. Not sure whether I deserve it or not. But acknowledging all the blessings, showers of blessings that all of you have given, I'll try to do justice, as I'm sure Lakshmi will. Moving forward, I've been called upon to evaluate today's meet. We'll see about that. I hope I don't shoot myself in the foot. I'm afraid I might already have. But today's meet will be will also be evaluated by a tag team, which I'm privileged to introduce now. I believe I'll be receiving the help of timer, C.A. Ashok Gowda. Sir, would you like to introduce your role?
Unmute, sir. Unmute yourself, sir.
Thank you, Satish, sir. Thank you, GE, and good evening, eloquent professionals. So as a time manager, my role would be keeping a track on the time taken by all the speakers and also the role takers. So I'll be displaying like this for the minimum time taken by the speakers. And when they're in the middle of the time taken, I'll display like this. And whenever the maximum time is done, I will display like this. And I'd like to also inform that, so you'll not be in the voting if you have taken beyond the time specified, that is maximum time. Over to GE. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. A precise, concise introduction as a timer should give. Moving on to the grammarian and the accounter, I believe we have CA Babita Madam.
Hello, everybody. My role will be to count the number of fillers used, like a, u, the, and I will also be talking about good usage and bad usage of words or sentences. That will be my role for the day. Thank you.
Thank you, madam. I'll also be joined by individual evaluators. I think Lakshmi will be joined by individual evaluators, CA Satish sir and CA Rajkumar sir. But the overall objective of mine today individually is to learn. I hope that I can start, or rather continue, this journey that I have been trying to set up for myself of learning consistently, continuously, endlessly, not mindlessly or needlessly, but continuously. That's my role of the day. I hope I've not missed any role players. No, I think have we all of them? Satish sir?
Yes, Mr. Vishal. That's good to
know. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So I leave it in capable hands of Satish.
Thank you, Ms. Lakshmi and Mr. Vishal. Friends, we all face adversities from time to time, but some of us are able to flourish when things get difficult, while others seem to struggle getting out of the bed in the morning Successful people have found a way to jump hurdles and navigate around roadblocks that would stop others completely. How is that some people can bounce back and find a way to overcome misfortune and defeat? For one, they don't allow themselves to become overwhelmed with negative emotions or thoughts. They take time to process what they have been through. Then they resume moving forward. Their mental fortitude lifts them up to seek opportunities instead of dwelling in despair. So let us get started with today's session. We are going to firstly have the prepared speeches lined up for you. Now, I'm going to call upon this person who qualified the Chartered Accountancy examination in the year 2004 and has since served many transnational companies such as Deloitte, Cisco, and General Electric in various capacities. Currently, she is a practicing chartered accountant and has keen interest in forensic audits, which is my forte as well, which I think so. And she's also pursuing the course on forensic audit and fraud detection from ICI. Music is her passion, and Ilayaraja is her favorite music composer. Her culinary skills are amazing, and preparing biryani is her finest cuisine. And we hope one fine day, she's going to invite every one of us to cherish and relish the dinner, culinary skills with biryani and many more stuff. So friends, please encourage the speaker by showing your thumbs up. So let us welcome our versatile speaker for today's evening, Ms. Sri Vidya Lakshmi. And she's going to be evaluated by none other than myself. And she's going to talk about a general topic. Let us try to see what she has installed for us. So let's open up the floor for her, and the screen is all for you, ma'am. Please, over to you, Ms. Vidya.
Thank you. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. Hello, fellow eloquent professionals. Good evening. Today I'm going to talk about WhatsApp medications, which is growing in a big way these days. We are seeing many things which is being forwarded, lots of things, and especially during this lockdown and when people were worried about the virus and other issues, there were lots of messages being forwarded which were pulling you down and creating uncertainty in your minds actually. Everyone was suggesting to follow different medications to avoid the virus. You could have seen people giving lots of suggestions to boost your immunity. Drink ginger lemon water. Do steam inhalation or add garlic, pepper, ginger in all. You would have seen lots of suggestions, forwarded messages, and all the other things. So this can also be said as too much of knowledge. Actually, what you are receiving these days, is it good or bad? Sometimes we also say too much of knowledge will hold you back, actually. So you are seeing lots of things, and especially after this COVID-19, you are seeing lots and lots of forwarded messages, which sometimes take you, put you down, or sometimes it also makes you feel, yeah, you're comfortable. So these are the various things which I thought, okay, these are the many things what we are seeing these days, which is good or bad, which we will talk about actually. So also there were lots of home remedies which were suggested, but these are all the home remedies which were followed in old days, long back, which we were following for some small fever, cough, cold, and the whole home remedies which we were following. But all these things were forgotten long back. And maybe we can say this COVID-19 has recreated all these things. It all brought the old things back so that we were all started following the olden procedures. What we were following, which we have forgotten, is being brought back. Also, we would have also experienced certain things. In case if there is a pain in the knee or any other problem or difficulty, what we do is we immediately Google and find out what could be the problem. for fundamental knowledge of the problem, this is good and can think what next, whom to consult and so on. But what we do not stop there. We also see what would be the problem, what could be the reason, what is the medication available. And even when we visit a doctor, we don't stop there. We even before the doctor is diagnosing, we even suggest to him saying, I think I have Googled, this could be the problem, this is the medication they have given. And also we only go to the doctor to confirm whether what we have Googled is right or wrong, but we do not allow the doctor to diagnose and say, this is your problem, this is the problem, so this is the medication you have to undergo. We do not allow them. Sometimes even in a professional capacity, we would have faced the problems like where we are suggesting, so these are the benefits you are available, you are in, allowed to take under the income tax, but that person will not stop with that. He will come back and say, no, no, I have Googled, I have seen on the net, these are all the benefits I can claim. Why is this stopping? He will never allow us to say no. There are some restrictions subject to and all the other things he will never allow you to say. So sometimes we feel too much of knowledge, is it good or bad? We have to think it over. So is it really good for us to have so much of knowledge, or we have to restrict ourselves and give it to the experts for them to decide whether how to proceed, what to do next, and all these things. So here I'm not actually hurting any of the persons, but only I want to say these are all the things we have to follow. We have to take it as a fundamental knowledge, basic knowledge, and at least to relax ourselves. But we should not go in depth and step into other person's profession and say, no, no, this is the thing has to happen. This is what I have to do. So it will always be easy for us. Have a very easy life. Don't complicate the life. Don't think too much. Too much of knowledge sometimes will also hold you back. And as the idiom is also there, we should not take too much of knowledge and shoot in our own foot. That's also there. I'm not hurting any of the person. Knowledge is good. Trying to know what is happening around us and what are the better ways to combat, all is good. But too much of knowledge without understanding properly becomes riskier. So to conclude, I will say, be positive and believe yourself. Good things will happen and all things will be safe. All will be safe and all things will get over. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Vidya. Yes, that was really what you call a wonderful deliberations in terms of what is the medication we are supposed to follow in times of COVID-19. And one interesting thing what I found was about the diagnosis which many of us are doing. I, in fact, was watching a television program where Dr. Manjunath of Jayadeva Cardiology Institute of Science, he was mentioning these days most of us are going with Google knowledge. I think that's a well-addressed topic that you did bring it to our notice, that diagnosis, self-diagnosis is never good. So we have to believe in the experts because they are experts. Of course, you did bring the analogy of a chartered accountant. So anything you try to do on your own and mess up, I think we are going to face a trouble at a later point in time. Okay, friends, now moving on. You may be aware there are a few ways how successful people push through adversity and bolster themselves, even when facing disasters. So some of the interesting factors to bear in mind would be to be mentally prepared, take stock of all that you have been through already. Adversity offers valuable insights that you should bear in mind. Okay, then embrace adversity as a chance for opportunity, because being consistent gives us a lot of opportunity to embrace adversity and become more successful. And interesting thing is, never be what you call never give up anything in life. Refuse to give up. That would be a more apt word, I would say. Believe in your capabilities. So these are brilliant advices one, I think, should pick up to become a lot more successful. So now with this, I'm driving the point to introduce another fantastic speaker of this forum. And it's always a privilege listening to him. Being the past president of Bangalore CA Toastmasters Club, he's a finest human being with rich knowledge in taxation. He's also passionate about yoga, And one important quality we should all envy, and what I love about him is he's such a down-to-earth person with so much of knowledge and experience. He still reminds that being humble is very important for every one of us. So, ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together in welcoming today's speaker, CA Rajkumar sir. And his individual evaluator will be our own chairman, Mr. Siddesh. I request now Mr. Siddesh to please explain your role in terms of individual evaluation. He is attempting Project 8, I believe. Over to you, Mr. Siddesh.
Thank you, sir. CA Rajkumar sir is attempting Project 8, as mentioned, which is to do with knowing your audience. Very important, very relevant project selected by the speaker. The objectives of the speech are: learn about the importance of researching the audience before the speech and quickly establish rapport with them. Learn to tailor a speech to specific audience, venue, and context. Learn to observe the body language of the audience and establish a dialogue, adopting two subtle changes in the audience instead of just delivering a canon speech. So these are the objectives. Time allotted is up to 6 minutes. With that, over to the MC. To the speaker.
Thank you, MC Mr. Satish and Siddesh, for your kind words. Siddesh, I may take one to two minutes extra for completing this project. Is it okay? Fine. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Hello. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yeah. You can go ahead. Yeah. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much. It was around 5 p.m. in the evening. I was waiting for Mr. Sundar, director of a reputed company. Am I audible? Hello?
Yes, hello. Please go ahead, sir.
Yeah. It was around 5 p.m. in the evening. I was waiting for Mr. Sundar, a director of a reputed company. We were meeting for the first time, with no prior introduction. My friend, who made responsible for this meeting to happen, had shared some information about the person. Mr. Sundar was a scientist and worked in Oxford University. I went without any prior preparation for the meeting. After a few minutes, the director entered the room. We exchanged our identities. The director wasted no time and stated the requirements. The requirement was the preparation of budgets and other MIS requirements. The topic was relatively easy since I used to teach students and it was a bread and butter job. I began to explain him about the budgets and at the macro level, and educated him on the analysis and how to use it in the business. He asked me one question. Raj, in the past many said the same, but none delivered. What about you? I said, sir, I am the single point of contact. Call me anytime regarding the budgets. He was convinced, and within 15 days, I submitted my reports. Now, I am the statutory auditor for that company. Happy evening, Mr. MC, eloquent professionals, guests, ladies and gentlemen. Every day we meet new people. It may be for business or casual. Even at home, we are surrounded by our family members. The communication with them is the key for longevity of the relationship, and in turn, it helps us to scale up in the business and peace at home. Ladies and gentlemen, let me share my experience in dealing with the different people. Few years back, I happened to read an article called Dope 4 Personality Types. I felt it was fun, interesting to read. After finishing the article, one thing I understood was to become successful, we need to speak the way others listen to us. According to the Dope Personality Test, the people are divided into four types. They are called Dove, Owl, Peacock, and an Eagle. doubt. Remember, it's English, not Kannada. These personality types are people-oriented, very peaceful, loyal, friendly, and hardworking, and a great team players. They tend to avoid confrontation, change, or risk-taking. I mean, they're not very assertive people. We find them everywhere in our team, family, and as well friends. They love stories, especially the personal stories. Very predictable and agree clear and avoid conflicts. They emphasize on the word we. These are the characteristics of a supportive communication style. To reach out to the DAO, I use these techniques. All, they chase goals, but believe in achieving by themselves. Very structured people, emphasize on the facts and figures, love detailing, tend to go deep and thoughtful and analytical. Very serious and purposeful. Many army officers, policemen, top doctors, bank officials, and other professionals fall in this category. They are very organized, and the best possible way to gain to the trust is show them the documents. Use the analytical communication style. Before I meet these people, I prepare myself to collect as much details as possible, answer all their queries, and I do not take any initiative in the communication. I wait for the question and then I prefer to answer them. This way, I try to build a trust. The next is the peacock, the image conscious people and people oriented. They like to be surrounded by people, very colorful, love to talk and talk for a long period of time. About what? About themselves. Very attractive personalities, enthusiastic, curious, and expressive. They respond fast to the appreciation and praise. The best way to reach out to them is to communicate by using their initiating style. Many film stars, celebrities, and few successful people, especially in the marketing and sales department, fall in this category. The best way to reach out to them is by using highly enthusiastic tone. Share details on how the ideas improve their image. Finally, the boss, the eagle, are status conscious and goal oriented. They love to talk about strategies, goals, and achievements. They chase goals, take pride in achieving them at the shortest possible time, pay little attention to the details, love to get things done. We find them at the top management, like CEOs, MDs, and they do not like to beat around the bush. The best way to interact with them is to direct communication. Come to the point, no presentations. They appreciate and listen to the people who share big picture and problem-solving methods, and most importantly, the results. Friends, Mr. Sundar was a director responsible for overall growth of the company. He needed confident and someone taking up the responsibility for results. I assured him by sharing my method, how it can solve his problems, and by assuming the responsibilities. He was convinced and I was rewarded. By understanding the different styles of personalities and their likings, I'm sure we can lay a foundation for success in the business and in the relationships. Finally, a word of caution. All the married men and the boys, all these styles do not work with a wife. So please don't try. One thing is sure. At Eloquent Professionals, I learned to speak, but with my wife, I become a better listener. Before I sign off, I know still some more questions unanswered, like how to identify these four types of people. For that, you don't have a choice. You have to wait for my next speech. Thank you. Over to Mr. MC.
Thank you, Rajkumar, sir. That was really wonderful. And we hope and we are all waiting for the next soap opera to start up from your end to watch out what is there in your closet, because we are now become more intrigued by whatever you have deliberated. So let's all wait and watch what is Rajkumar sir is lined up for. Okay, so moving on, friends, we all know consistency is the hidden part to our success. And it's often difficult to start a new habit or to change an old behavior, isn't it? Don't you all agree with me? Yes. So there are enough books and courses online that teach us how to plan a day and how to organize our work. So filtering through various tasks that lies ahead of us. So in the midst of a lot of busy work, I believe there is something called as an hidden secret to anyone's success. And as our chairman already mentioned, consistency is the key for it. Yes, we all have to reflect that self-introspection will take us to the next level. So to take the quote of Dwayne The Rock Johnson, he goes on to say, I quote, success isn't always about greatness. It's about consistency. Consistent hard work leads to success. Greatness will come, unquote. So isn't that beautiful quote? I hope we all are going to take a lesson out of it. Now, moving on, we are going to have a second segment for the day, that is Pick and Speak. To conduct this event, now I'm going to call upon this interesting personality who hails from Solapur. Before getting into practice, he worked as a general manager, admin and accounts for MS Ramaya Group of Companies. He indeed dared to get married during the times of COVID-19. So let us all wish the newly wedded couple a very happy married life. And this celebrity did celebrate his birthday a couple of days back. And we, on behalf of all the forum members, wish both happy married life as well as happy birthday to this person whom I am referring to. He loves playing cricket and likes to read newspaper and books. He also likes to follow Indian politics closely. Friends, now to unravel the butterflies in your tummy, here's the person I'm going to present you, C.S. Saurav Lonawat. Over to you, sir. I think he left at the right moment. Let us give him a couple of more seconds wherein he's going to join. I think he Hello. Has joined back again. Yes, Mr. Saurav.
Yeah, good
nice
evening.
To see you back. Yeah, thank yes, you. Over to you.
Professionals.
Good evening. We can hear you. Please go ahead.
Yeah, yeah. Today I'll be taking table topics. As you are aware, table topics means I'll be throwing some topics at you and you need to grab those topics and give your speeches spontaneously on those topics. Time frame from this is 2 minutes. Let's start first. The topic for the today, table topic I would like to give is US and China relationship and its impact to India. Anyone would like to volunteer it? Hello.
It's better you nominate someone, Mr. Saurav, because as you're the table topic master, I think the master should run the show.
Okay. I would like to call on Sideshwar Rao to take this topic, India-US relationship, US-China relationship and its impact on India.
Hi, good evening, everyone. Hope I'm audible.
Yes, audible.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you for all the members for the opportunity. Today's topic is U.S. and China trade war and impact on India. So, USA is being the big brother for all the world's economy. So, who look at the US and China has been the is being the world's the country which has lots of industries and industries and all these and making the electronics and all other goods supplies to entire world. And yeah, so when there is a fight in between Big Brother and in a home, and it'll always disturb other members also. So yeah, and definitely this affected the most of the countries in the world. So and one of India is also one of the affected country. So yeah, I mean, I think in between China and in USA, so there are lots of issues going on right now. And we are also, neighboring country for China. So yeah, we are facing so many border issues with the China. So of course, it is definitely a bitter experience for all the countries. So yeah, that's all from my side. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you
Mr. Saurabh, you there? I think we had some entertainment in between. So this is all part and parcel of our virtual meeting. Let's enjoy. Yes, Mr. Saurabh, you there? Please unmute. Yeah, go ahead. Oops. Is left the meeting again. I think there's some issue since he's not seem to be seated in his place. I think he's back again. He's joined. Mr. Saurabh, you can you hear us?
Hello.
Yes, go ahead, please. Please go ahead.
Yeah. This was very nice. A brief introduction, brief details given by Siddheshwar about US-China relationship and its impact on the India being a smaller brother of China. The next topic I would like to give is to Ashok Gowda. The fame in depression. I'd like to repeat fame in depression.
Hello, can you repeat, sir? What is that in the depression?
I think example is an example of Sushant Singh. The fame he had all the fame, but he led to depression also.
Okay.
So fame in depression.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Saurabh, for the time. Wonderful subject given to me. That is fame in the depression. Depression is at this present situation or the present century. So you have been hearing about this word depression, and this has not left anybody in the. Are you trying to say something, sir?
No, I'm not trying to.
Okay. Thank you. So this depression has troubled many of the celebrities, and it has not left anyone in the world, because we have been hearing it from the top celebrities like Deepika Padukone, and we have been also heard this thing about the depression in the death of suicide of Sushant Singh Rajput. So my take on this particular thing about the depression is, yes, when we are in a top of the helm like a celebrity, as a superstar, when the depression taunts us, definitely it's not easy to cope up. It requires a very strong mental strongness, and we should be very strong enough from within, not bothered by whatever happens outside us. That means the external affairs, like maybe our rating is going down, or maybe our competitors, what they are doing, and what others are thinking about us, and what others are feeling about us. No, we should be mentally strong, and we should have all the courage to face whatever comes in the path we are taking. So even it's a celebrity or a common man like you and me, so we should not get affected by the external environment. We should be strong enough from within and face whatever challenges comes our way. So we should be strong from within. So with this, I'd hand over back to MC, the table topic master rather. Thank you
Ashok Gowda for giving such a detailed explanation about what leads to depression, and giving the examples of the person who have dealt with this successfully. That is Deepika Padukone example you have given, also the methods by which we can cope up all the depression, because it's a very highly tense situation nowadays because of COVID-19. Everyone is under tremendous pressure. I think that was a nice speech given by Ashok Gowda. Next topic I would like to give to Shri Vidya Lakshmi, and the topic is tips for happy married life. I repeat, tips for happy married life.
Yeah. Things for happy married life, correct, right?
Yeah, yeah. Yes, ma'am, it's correct.
So,
go ahead.
Yes. Okay, thank you. These days, marriage life going on for a long time is all being big debatable things and all. So a right question asked, tips for, this is from my point of view, maybe it differs from person to person, but give and take, and that is the main thing. And also we have to give the space for our spouse also. They have their own personal space, which the other person also has to respect. So this is one of the major things which I feel is necessary for a happy married life. Give and take, and also adjustability. It's not that always you have to fight for either small things or the big things. It's always understanding the position of the others. If you try to understand yourself in other person's perspective, then there will be always peace in the family. This is for a happy married life. Maybe a small tip, but that will always take you a very long way. Thank you.
Thank you, Vidyalakshmi ma'am. I think this tip will gonna help me and all the youngsters who are coming up, lined up here, Siddhesh, most probably. You have correctly pointed that impact is very much required for a successful marriage or any relationship. Having understanding other perspective is very much required. Thank you so much. The next topic is to Sachin. That is, topic is IPL in UAE. I repeat, IPL in UAE.
Thank you, Saurabh, for the topic. So IPL UAE. Yeah, I'm being a fan of IPL. Of course, I would welcome this decision taken by the BCCI along with the IPL management committees. So we know that in India, it's predominantly affected by the COVID cases. So I don't think it's feasible to undertake such an event in India. So, and I also know that most of the entertainments are like, it was either banned or it was like due to lockdown, we are not able to enjoy how we used to enjoy previously. So now they are also conducting it without any audience. So basically the only way of watching the IPL is that by watching it in the TV or any other platform for that matter. So I think we can spend a very good time, and that is becomes a very important source for the people who likes the cricket. By sitting in home, we can watch the cricket, which is also safest way of watching an IPL. Because yes, of course, we are going to lose a kind of revenue in India because it has been shifted to UAE. But yet the major the importance of that IPL is to entertain the audience. So that is happening. So at least for me, I don't
think that it is a very big concern from the entertainment point of view. I'm looking forward for it, and I also hopefully expect that this time RCB will win the cup. So I also reiterate that slogan, Isala Cup Namde. So we'll wait and watch. Thank you. Over to you, Saurabh.
Thank you so much, Sachin. Even I wish you were the IPL Namde, Cup Namde. Most probably, I heard a joke recently that when May exams are there, that time also IPL is there. And this time when exams have been postponed to November, that time also IPL is there. So I think IPL doesn't go in hand with the students. That's a joke. And the next topic I would like to give is to Rajkumar, sir.
Saurabh, you have to swap that because Rajkumar sir has just left. He may join. Maybe you can give the topic to someone else.
Okay. I would like to block this in place. Hello. May I know who is this block this in place?
Babita, madam. That's Miss Babita. Please go ahead.
Oh, Babita, okay. Babita, ma'am, topic for you is boost to economic revival. What kind of boost will be required for the economic revival?
Can you repeat?
What kind of boost is required for economic revival?
Good evening, everybody. I forgot to acknowledge initially everybody. So for economic revival, what goods are required? So personally, according to me, we need a lot of consumer items, agro goods, and goods which can keep us going for day-to-day necessities. Generally it is a luxury items which has a major role in any economic revival. But right now, facing the pandemic situation, I think we have to concentrate more on the necessities rather than luxuries. And we need such industries to thrive which can take up manufacturing on a large scale, which can boost the economy instantly. We also need such industries to come up which can have a turnover or rollover immediately, which has a very low gestation period. And we also need such industries which require very minimum working capital. So I personally feel these are the industries which should be given more importance. And I also feel industries which can give more employment opportunities to others should definitely find a place in our industrial policy today. So that's it from my side. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, Babita ma'am. I think your points pointed by the Babita ma'am, as I say, will definitely, when required by the Nirmala Sitharaman, will definitely place it. Thank you so much for this, for the boosting of the economy. Do you have a few more time available?
Last one topic, Rajkumar sir.
Last one topic, Rajkumar sir. Yes. New professional things you have learned in lockdown.
Few professional things which you have learned in lockdown.
Lockdown, yeah.
Thank you. Good evening, Table Topic Master. And every stressful situation offers an opportunity to excel and learn something. This time, the pandemic has offered me the confidence in clearing the valuation exams. I'm preparing for the valuation exams. For some time, I lost hopes and I lost the interest in completing the exams. However, two of my friends, one, Ravi, was behind me to take up the exams with me, and one of my other friends, Ramakrishna, he said one thing: "You are younger than me, and you are now, I mean, you are more knowledgeable, but why don't you clear the exams? Now, that word changed my thinking. I started preparing myself. Now, I think I'm more confident to clear that exams than before. The pandemic, if I've taken it in the right spirit, definitely we can excel. But if we try to think about what is going to happen tomorrow, probably we are wasting our time. So the biggest lesson what I've learned is the toughest times in your life will produce the greatest results of your life. So that is a lesson I've learned in the pandemic. Thank you.
That was a very much motivating speech that he has utilized the time in a productive way and also encouraged us to look into today, not about tomorrow, what is going to happen. Hence, today we had a very varied topic today, from starting which are currently related to all situation which we are going facing through. With this, I would like to hand over to our MC of the day, Satish, sir.
Thank you, Mr. Saurabh. That was indeed a very unique way, and you had come up with very interesting topics that are relevant in today's pandemic situation. And most of the participants were able to give justice to the topic which was thrown out by you. And most of them have really loved it, I believe. Okay. Now, moving on, friends, we are at the last stage of today's program. This is what we all look forward to. So that is the most important segment, I would call, of today's meeting, that is evaluation. Evaluation is something like sandwiching the affirmations. If there is any tepid critics, I think the evaluators are going to help us, encouraging to tell us what went wrong, what were good, and many more things. So without much ado, I now call upon our today's joint evaluators, Ms. Lakshmi and Mr. Vishal, to please give your evaluation report. Over to you, Ms. Lakshmi.
Lakshmi, would you like to take up?
Kindly unmute yourself, Ms. Lakshmi.
Yeah, I would like to hand over this part to Vishal because he'll be the one who is doing the initial part. I would be evaluating the prepared speech. Over to you, Vishal.
Thank you, Lakshmi. I think we'll follow the flow of the meet to go ahead about the evaluation. I would like to initiate with the disclaimer. The following are personal opinion of a student who has probably shot himself in the leg. At the risk of repetition, I'd like to reiterate that who is not yet realized that he is about to evaluate his mentors and probably doesn't know what he's doing. But to honor the requests and the blessings of all the mentors here, I'd like to take this leap and try to do justice to this job. We started the meet on time. 1 or 2 minute delays is but normal. Starting on time is something that I personally deeply appreciate. It is something to be celebrated about. First of all, I'd like to start with the congratulations for the consistency with which this Eloquent Professionals Forum has conducted itself. I'm very surprised and equally not surprised, but happy to hear that this is the 20th e-online meet that is happening and 46th all over. It is but expected when such professionals are existing here, have taken the lead and are taking this to great heights. This GE part is quite unusual for me because I'm not yet a professional. Eloquent is yet to be decided. But moving on to the evaluation part, we started the meet with the Sergeant at Arms who gave the good intro. As the Sergeant at Arms spoke, I became more comfortable with the meet. That I think that speaks the best thing, that is the best thing that I could come up with, because the main objective of Sergeant at Arms is to initiate everybody, and that was, I think, done very beautifully, very subtly. I didn't realize it, and I think that's, if you ask me personally, that is one of the greatest skills that an orator must possess. The sergeant at arms was very confident. He had a very good flow. And the quote about Bruce Lee got me. I mean, I'm a huge Bruce Lee fan. 1,000 kicks and one kick is all the difference in the world. And I'll certainly keep this in mind and move forward. Thank you for that quote. One alternate that I could think of was a little bit about energy. This is maybe just my personal opinion, but a little more energy and pizzazz could probably be an alternate approach and could be worthy of thinking about. Intro to other members was also very much to be appreciated about. When someone calls or introduces somebody else, it depends on, it highly influences their confidence level as well as the speech that they're about to present. The introduction is one of the most crucial things that can ever happen in a forum like this. And the introduction of the presiding officer was very good. It gave, it did the intended things. Overall, very good, sir. Thank you very much for that particular role today. One other alternative that I could think as a, as the entire meet progressed was regarding cliches. Again, this is a personal opinion, but I don't like cliches. Maybe they act as good connectors. Maybe we could think of some other things and come up with some creative and better answers. But that is, again, in my personal opinion. Before moving forward, I'd like to call upon the timer of the day, for I'd like to hear the reports and then go about the rest of the evaluation. I'd like to call upon the timer, CA Ashok Gowda, sir.
Thank you, GE. So we have started our meeting at 5:03. So 5:03 we have started the meeting. Sergeant at arms for the day, Sachin, took 3:20. President Siddesh sir took 12 minutes. And coming to prepared speeches, so Srividya madam has taken 5:21.
Sorry, sir. But could you also indicate how many minutes the particular role players are supposed to take?
Okay. I think we don't have a limit as far as the president is concerned and sergeant at arms is concerned. But prepared speech, minimum time allowed is 4 minutes and maximum is 6 minutes. And in case of table topics, 1 minute is minimum and 2 minute is maximum. So coming to prepared speeches, time taken, Srividya madam has taken 5:21. Rajkumar sir in the prepared speech has taken 8 minutes. Coming to table topics, Sideshwara Rao has taken 1:49. Ashok has taken 2:12. Vidyalakshmi has taken 1:03. Sachin has taken 1:31. Babita madam has taken 1:30. Rajkumar sir has taken 1:30. That's all from my side, G.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for that very concise and precise, as the timer should be, as you already had represented earlier. I believe that time is something that should not be wasted at any cost. It was handled very nicely, sir. I hope that I was also timed. I'm sorry that I forgot to inform earlier, but I hope I am also being timed. Moving on with the meeting, the presiding officer, Siddesh sir, has spoken for about 12 minutes, but frankly speaking, I never realized that sir took about 12 minutes. This is, I believe, a really intimidating part for me. But I'd like to progress ahead anyway. Sir is master when it comes to alliteration, and his consistency with the theme, both of his speech and regarding the theme of the meet, is to be appreciated about. Sir started with a question and linked the entire speech to, in the end, with his question, which I believe is the most impactful manner any speech could be done. Again, this is a personal opinion. One more thing that I learned from sir today was the use of cameras. being this a virtual meet, the use of body language is something that might hinder or may not hinder certain people. But being a virtual meet, sir used the camera to its fullest advantage. Sir had it in the most ideal situation where we could see sir's body language, how sir was conducting the entire meet. That is something that I did not realize that could be done. And sir did it very, very subtly and very beautifully. Thank you, sir, for that. Your quotes and books about income tax is something that I would like to hear anyway. So please, whenever we meet, please continue to talk on the same, sir. I would love to hear them. You spoke on the theme very well, sir. I got the grip that you were intending to portray. Very good language was used, sir, as always. Candle in front of sun and the other quotes that you gave. A small daily task, if be it really daily, will be the labors of spasmodic Hercules, is something that I'll carry with me forever, hopefully. Sun Tzu is something that I also look forward to. I have not read his book, The Art of War, but I'd like to read one day. And the amount that an ant can get things done more than a bull is something that I'd like to cherish again. Your presence of mind is to be appreciated, sir, but not to be surprised upon, because you consistently kept commenting in the chat box regarding whatever was happening and to help the head to streamline the entire meet and ensure that it was conducted in a very smooth manner. You brought in the humor through your introduction of Satish sir, sir, and this is something that most people out of context will not believe, that it all of us together are proud to be called, hopefully called as ants. I didn't think of any situation where this could be something that I would cherish upon, but I believe if I were to be called an ant, I would be really happy. Your intro is to set an example. You introduce Satish sir with a quotation like, to set an example is the best thing a man can look forward to. I completely agree with you, sir. I always look forward to all of you here, especially Satish sir. And it is but apt to use such phrases for Satish sir. Overall, I don't think I can add any or even conceive to add any points to your presentation, sir. But I have taken away a lot of things from your presentation. I think that is the best achievement. Now moving on to Satish sir. Satish sir, being an MC is like a cherry on the icing that the cake has already received. Perhaps even a dessert too, most preferably jamun. I like jamuns. Sir started with the structure of the meet, which was very eloquently introduced. I think I was familiarized with it. Being a newcomer, I think that does the best job. His introduction to all these speakers were to be something to be really appreciated about. Because as I said earlier, introduction is the most important thing when it comes to a forum like this. Very interesting intro to the session, sir, because you carried on a theme that related to this, but also took its own turn. You kept on talking about success and how it really matters to us, its different facets. I really enjoyed that, sir. You strung the entire speaks. You sprinkled it throughout your presentation, which I believe is the best thing that I could have got out of this. You continued the view regarding success. Your body language also is something to be appreciated about, sir. I believe Siddhesh sir and Satish sir are someone I will take the cue from and position my camera a little bit better so that my body language also can be better portrayed. When you quoted about Dwayne Johnson, sir, I think I'm a huge fan of Dwayne The Rock Johnson. Success isn't about greatness. Consistency is success, and greatness will follow. Today is sprinkled with so many pearls that I don't know what I'll do with such bag full of them. I think next session is about prepared speakers. I'd like to hand it over to Lakshmi.
Yeah, thank you, Vishal. Good evening once again to the members of Eloquent Professionals. Today I'll be evaluating the prepared speech session. Before I start with my evaluation, I would again like to reiterate the same disclaimer that this is my professional view, I mean personal view. I also would like to tell that it's an honor and a pleasure to be evaluating. Before I proceed, I would like to first call upon the individual evaluator for the first project that was given by Vidya ma'am. I would like to ask Satish sir to give his report on his individual evaluation. Over to you, Satish sir.
Thank you, G ma'am. Today I had this opportunity to evaluate a person whom I didn't know much about, but I had a couple of interactions. And what I liked the most about this personality was the cheerful smile she sported when she opened up. Though I think later on she was a little away from the camera, probably as Mr. Vishal already pointed out, something which we all have to work on. So that apart, I think she had a great smile, and I really enjoyed the way she started her presentation in terms of posing a question with regard to what is there in the WhatsApp, uncertainty in every one of our mind. So that was really what you call a thought-provoking phrase to start off with a presentation. She had a lot of inputs for us to ponder during this pandemic. And some of the interesting things which I could jot down were in terms of the home remedies which we people are carrying out during this pandemic. Then what are the procedures that are being followed in the olden days? So taking the advice of a doctor is something we all are refraining. Rather, we are, going to the Google Baba to get these diagnoses done. I think that is a little bit of a danger. So she had a message for all of us that do not do such thing. If we have to take an expert advice, we all should go. So that was very well captured. And she did bring about the knowledge of an expert, how one should appreciate and take. And somewhere she left another point for all of us to ponder also. Too much of knowledge isn't good for any one of us. So that's something. There's a saying in Kannada, Echadre Amrutano Visha. So something of that analogy, I fully concur with her. She was very fluent in her structuring of sentences. She was to the point. A few areas, if I were to dwell upon for Ms. Vidya, would be to pick up a few quotes here and there to make her presentation look a lot better, so that it captures the imagination of the audience, and they would be more interested, and would make her speech more effective. If she could have certain examples in her presentation, that would have made things even more better and would have given more clarity. So those are a couple of observations. In terms of the main point of OBC, which we call the opening body and conclusion, I think she could have rather intertwined a lot more ideas and a little more slogans and quotes with a little more practical or personal experiences, because she spoke about the present pandemic situation. I think, ma'am, if you could have cherished all these inputs in your presentation, I think that would have been one of the beautiful presentation. That's my analysis, and back to you, G.
Thank you, sir. Excellent analysis, and I totally concur with Satish, sir. I like the thing, the topic was true, actually very apt. I mean, I actually had heard about the story wherein a kid read on WhatsApp that alcohol, that apparently the hand sanitizer kills corona, and the kid went ahead and drank it. So this is how bad if the information is bombarded, and this is what happens. However, luckily nothing happened to the kid. That's a good thing. So I thought that the topic was really apt. I loved your voice. Your voice is very soothing for me. I felt it very soothing. Your content also was pretty clear. You also used idiom in your speech. Towards the end, you used the idiom of the day. So that was a really good point. If there was something to be better, it would be on the positioning of the camera. Since the virtual meet, we'll have to position it in such a way that we are visible. Apart from that, it was a really great speech, and thank you very much, ma'am. Now I would request the individual evaluator who was evaluating Rajkumar sir to give his report. Over to you, Siddesh sir.
Thank you, Miss Lakshmi. A plane which is taking off from Bangalore, if it is heading towards any of the cities, maybe let's take Beijing for example, for about 95%+ of the time it is off the course. The pilot or maybe autopilot which is there, it is in place only to ensure that the course is corrected only for about 5% of the time, so that the destination is reached. So Rajkumar sir had undertaken similar journey when he joined Eloquent Professionals or maybe Toastmasters or maybe any public speaking journey. Maybe, or maybe in the very last meeting, he was commented upon the angle of the camera. Today he course corrected and ensured that it was perfect possible angle. The body language, the posture, I think everything was centered, well centered and well organized. He was also commented upon the body language. He was holding mic, the headset, which crippled his body language. Today he course corrected, ensured that that was not there. The ammunition which he had was there at his disposal. Today he also ensured that the body language was very wide open. I always refer to Narendra Modi if I want to refer open body language. Donald Trump if I want to refer open body language. It is only because of that open body language they have gone on to win elections. So today Rajkumar sir had similar open body language, that is also highly appreciated. Maybe he was also commented upon the message organization. Maybe he was also commented upon need for bringing about anecdotes, need for making it very simple to the audience or making very very relevant to the audience. Today he ensured, he course corrected and ensured that he made it very relevant. He also brought about humor which was relevant to the crowd. The statutory auditor example and the husband-wife relation, he said these four things, dog, owl, peacock, all those things can be experimented in Eloquent Professionals or maybe outside world, but not before. But not before what? Your smile says it all. Yes, but not before wife. So people remember his message. That is the impact which he had through his speech. Sir, I do not wish to evaluate your speech. Rather, I would like to thank you today at the earliest possible opportunity. The moment it is uploaded on YouTube or Google Drive, I would go back and watch your speech all again, because so many things to learn from your speech, the pauses, the pace at which you spoke, all those things. It was a perfect possible speech which I have come across. Very heartening to see the progress which you have clocked till date in Eloquent Professionals, sir. Having said that, being course correcting all the time, you have ensured that you have cleared this course of Project 8 successfully, sir. Back to Madam Lakshmi.
Thank you, sir. Yeah, truly. I mean, every time Rajkumar sir used to come and sir used to tell how important it is to start with a story. And today, listening to your speech, I learned a lot. I mean, it was truly a blessing to be here and to listen to your speech. I loved the way how you started with the story. I loved your gestures, probably when you're telling peacock, you did something like this. And I was just looking at you and your gesture and I was totally mesmerized. I mean, I have no words, but it was truly a pleasure and a great speech. Very good pauses. That is something I will also pick on, how and where to give a pause. Energy levels also were perfect and the voice modulation also was pretty good, and also how you always looked at the camera when you were speaking, that was also pretty good. Overall, I mean, I have no words. It was by far one of the best speeches I have seen. So thank you, sir. Over to Vishal to carry on with the other part of the evaluation. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Lakshmi, and all this for this wonderful evaluation. I'd like to refer to Rajkumar sir's speech, because it's certain I was a little bit lazy prepared speech session not being evaluated by me. Maybe it's a human condition, or I'm taking the liberty to blame it on that I was not listening to it as intently as I should have. Thank God that it is being uploaded to YouTube so that I can go back and re-listen and learn from it But I did, when sir started talking about different personalities, dove, owl, again English dove, peacock and eagle, it really pulled me back. So it was a very impactful speech, sir. I took certainly a lot of things away from it. Thank you for that speech, sir. Moving ahead with the table topic, the table topic master, again, being an e-meet, it is but expected to have few issues regarding network and the technology involved. But overlooking all that, the table topic master ensured that the table topic meet was done quite nicely, quite elegantly. The table topic master had very relevant topics. It was very, and he also ensured that he could connect between the speeches. He reflected back on what the prior speaker talked about and then went on to the next speaker. Thanks to your questions, sir, I learned a lot of new things regarding economy, regarding other things that is quite relevant right now. It certainly gave me new ideas. I believe that's the best way that a butterfly session or a table topic session should be done. One alternative that I could think upon was maybe a little bit more energy. And one thing that I could learn, that I have learned from Srikasa Speakers Forum, is again, this was suggestions by mentors itself, that maybe first tell the entire topic, get it through to all the speakers, probably pause for a little bit to get the butterflies going, then announce the name of the speaker so that it truly becomes a butterfly session. Perhaps that could have been an alternative that could be looked upon, sir. You were very confident nonetheless, and you conducted the meet through grace. Thank you for that wonderful, insightful table topic session, sir. Sir, I would like to confirm with Satish sir and Siddhesh sir that I don't have to comment upon the individual table topic speakers, or should I? Should I comment, sir?
Not required. It's up to you. If you have anything great or something you had to ponder, it's a learning for all of us. Nonetheless, I think I leave it to your wisdom.
Okay, sir. Taking a cue from all of you, I'd like to leave it to the persons themselves, because it is a butterfly session. I believe it should be introspection rather than extrospection. I hope that's a word. So moving on, overall, I'd like to say this has been a very insightful meeting for me, a new experience, something that from which I will come up as a better public speaker, a better person, perhaps. One alternative that I could again think of, again, borrowing from the speakers forum, is maybe the idea of the entire meet being timed could be looked upon. I am somewhat a person who Rajkumar sir referred to as an owl. I don't understand unorganized things. Maybe perhaps that is why this is sticking out in my mind. The idea of the sergeant at arms being timed, then the presiding officer, then the MC, and then the entire meet, including the GE. Perhaps that could be looked upon. Before I call upon grammarian, I'd like to... No, let's just go ahead and call the grammarian. Then I'd like to conclude the entire evaluation. I believe grammarian and our counter is both being carried on by Babita ma'am. Ma'am, please.
Thank you, T. Vishal. Today the session was very mesmerizing, and there were a lot of good usage of English vocabulary and lot of idioms and quotes. And sorry I missed Sergeant Tom's speech, but Siddesh, he used a lot of good quotes and a lot of good words like spectacle, apprehensions, spasmodic, hercules. And Satish sir, I don't know what to say about him. A lot of rhyming words like mindlessly, carelessly, cherish and relish, lot of idioms, quotes, and like he could relate to the topic very well today, and used consistently a lot of good words like unravel the butterflies, navigate around roadblocks, dwelling in despair. They were all good usage of words. And Vishal sir also had a lot of good words, alliteration, then cherry on the icing. And Sri Vidya, she had a very good quote, too much of knowledge will also hold you back.
Rajkumar sir, all of you have already commented about good usage. Then Siddheshwar, he was good. Ashok Gowda also was good. When it comes to R counters, Siddhesh had around 2 R counters and Satish sir had around 7. But it's normal throughout the round if he has taken 7. And Vishal sir, few. Srividya had around 8 to 9 R counters. And Rajkumar sir had only 2, which is great. Siddheshwar had few. Ashok Gowda had too many, around 6. Again, Sachin Deshpande had 3. I too had 3-4. And regarding wrong usage, when it comes to GE, I think I should not be mentioning anybody's name. There was repeated usage of lot of words, like I believe, in my personal opinion. And too much of knowledge that was used many times, good and bad was used n number of times, could have been replaced by right and wrong or beneficial. And was scientist could have been used as was a scientist. Then strongness could have been replaced with strength. We have been heard, should have been, we have heard. We have so many border issues, can be, we have many border issues. Like there were a lot of prefixes before many words, before many nouns or verbs, which is not required. Then somebody used tremendous for tremendous. Likes the cricket. It could have been like cricket. I like cricket. I think that's it from me. Thank you again. Over to you, Ji.
Thank you, madam. Thank you, ma'am, for the evaluation. I was eager to hear what my evaluation would be. And I am of the personal opinion, again, at the risk of criticism from you, that it would be better to include the person who has got the usage wrong and then perhaps encourage them to improve. One more thing, again, taking a leave from Siddhesh sir, at this point, I'm taking the entire book from sir, but a good pause, good usage of pauses could be highlighted. That is something that I've consciously learned to control, and then it has improved my quality of speech. I will certainly take the criticism of avoiding arts and not to personalize my opinions in verbal. Overall, this entire meet has been something that I would really look back upon, cherish, and learn from, and I have learned from it a lot. The fact that it is being uploaded to YouTube was a surprise to me. So I could really go back and look upon all the mistakes that I also did and learn to improve. One thing that I am moved by the particular forum is the commitment to improve. Nobody takes it personally, but objectively. That is something that I really, really like. Thank you for this honor. I speak for both Lakshmi and me. This has been an honor of a lifetime. Thank you all. I'd like to hand it over back to the MC.
Thank you, Mr. Vishal. That was simply wonderful. I would call it so memorable for all of us, and all the participants would definitely agree with me. It was simply momentous. The evaluation from the prodigies of our profession, I would call it, the future leaders, I thoroughly enjoyed and cherished it with your insights and a lot of inputs and learning that we are going to take from today's meeting. Now, before we conclude, I request our chairman come presiding officer, Mr. Siddhesh Gaji, to give his closing remarks. Over to you, Mr. Chairman. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Satish sir. It has been a wonderful experience, wonderful time. Since 5 o'clock, I thoroughly enjoyed it. The amount of smile I had to project, it has started paining. So thank you, Avadhoot, Vishal, and Lakshmi Shenoy, for making it to today's meeting. I would request each and everybody who is present here in today's meeting to take just about a minute to take the survey which is there in the comment box. Nonetheless, results will be announced after the session. You can go about with that. And with respect to YouTube, if you are not comfortable with this meeting being hosted online, you can get in touch with me, leave a personal message. I may consider cutting the part, relevant part. That is one. And secondly,
sorry folks, I think we're having some technical glitch. Just hold on for a few seconds just before Mr. Siddesh comes back and gives his closing remarks. I hope we all have that patience. Let's just give him a few more seconds. At the meantime, I also request all the participants to please take up the survey form, Google survey form, and give your feedback. I think that will help us in announcing the winner for this week. Rajkumar, sir, you there? Hello? Hello, Rajkumar, sir, are you there?
Yes, tell me, Satish.
Yeah, sir. Can you just give a couple of your closing remarks for today's meeting? Because I think by the time Mr. Siddesh joins us back, I request you to please give your closing remarks from your end.
Yeah. Today, it's a fantastic day because two of our mentees are evaluating the whole meeting. It's a fabulous thing, and especially the way Vishal and Lakshmi had progressed in the Sikasa Toastmasters, it's a treat to watch those two guys. One suggestion I would like to give them is, you know, you don't need to be apologetic, or you don't need to be add excuses to your duty. Because what you're doing is a job, and as an evaluator, you are just doing your duty. Whatever you feel like evaluating, please go ahead. Don't worry about who is there in front of you. It doesn't matter. It's going to be your mentors, or it's going to be your parents, or it's going to be your best friends. Don't worry about it, because you are asked to evaluate, and your duty to evaluate. And don't add any biases to it. With that, there are a lot of good things to learn today. The people's participation here is so encouraging. I'm really overwhelmed by the encouragement given. Personally, I would like to attend the EP just to be in be competitive, because the moment I see the youngsters who are just starting their journey, it gives me a competitive spirit, so that I can also compete with them and learn something, and I can also better it from my side. So, Eloquent Professionals is a perfect example and a place where you can improve upon. That's it from my side. Over to you.
Thank you, Rajkumar, sir. I completely agree with your analysis, and the general evaluators need not be what you call scared or be apologetic for the position they hold, because we all view you as a general evaluator, and that position and post has high regards for every one of us. So whatever the positives or whatever be the negatives or the wrongdoings we have done, if you as the general evaluators giving justice to the role, we would always be what you call thankful, and this should continue, because the position of a general evaluator is to give an unbiased opinion and view of the entire proceedings. So I now request our chairman to finally conclude, because he had a little bit of a technical issues in between. So sorry to have roped in our other mentor, Dr. Rajkumar, to speak a few words before you were to join. Over to you, chairman, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. No, I'm thankful to Satish sir as well as Rajkumar sir for filling in. and for the valuable feedback. I totally agree with Rajkumar sir as well as Satish sir. In the very beginning of general evaluation, Avadhoot Vishal was skeptical. He was wondering whether he is eloquent or professional. Even Lakshmi had a similar disclaimer. The eloquence with which you both have conducted today, the professionalism that you have displayed, so you are the best possible eloquent professional for this forum. So I thank you for being part of this. And that being said, my final take on theme of the day is, we all know that knowledge is treasure. It is treasure. The only keys to that treasure is implementation. Let's all work towards consistency, because it has often produced results which we desire. If it is not consistent, it is not consistent. That's all. That being said, I would like to take cue from CA Satish sir. For you to be celebrity, you have to celebrate eloquent professionals by attending it on a regular basis. So thank you. Thank you all. I'll take survey results from each and everybody who attended this meeting. Thank you for making it today. One, yes. I forgot. May I request everybody to put on their camera. We will take a short group photo. Oops. I was so involved in the meeting, I forgot to take a photo.
Okay.
Yes, one second, please. Sorry.
Rajkumar sir, if you can please unmute your video, we would be more honored.
I'm sure Rajkumar sir will course correct next time. One second. I think I missed. Yes. Thank you. Thank you all for being part of the meeting. It was nice to have you all. Yes. See you.
Thank you. Thank you. Bye. Good night.
Bye. Good night.
Good night. Bye. Good night.